Yeah, no, that was regular bracket. The finesse took me out loser's side, and then winner's side it was gosh, I can't remember. They were playing Terry. I can't remember their tag. I'll have to look at it. I'm sorry.
Gotcha. No big deal. Alright, so we are getting started on Battlefield.
No more heroes.
LZ Glows and Nissan Algade. And there we go. We got the tags flopped around just a wee bit here, so. What do you think this match? Oh, no. Child gets pushed off stage by Evil Cat. Don't even need to lay a hand on him.
Right?
That ultimate heel move.
I don't know. I mean, like we were saying earlier, it's matchup-wise, it's very weird, right? Because, I mean, obviously, Ness can do a lot to harass him, so he's off stage. The lackluster recovery there. But in reality, Insuror has a lot of opportunities to get easy revenge stacks, and this is a light character and a big cat. There's not really much else to say there. But fantastic coverage from Luzenit Glows, as we've been calling them.
I genuinely don't know what you do there in that spot. If you have to recover high and they've already started that up, you're just toast, aren't you?
Speaking of toast, Jesus, you cooked them for like 53% right there.
Someone's cooking me up. Now, I will say, Nissan, like, had a lot of trouble in the set that I watched in Winterside, but, like, forced to a game three and got the victory in a pretty dominant fashion. It's one of those where, like, you get washed game one and then you come back and win the next two hard.
Ooh.
Good get up attack right there, getting around the yo-yo opportunity.
Oh, and that's funny that Lariat actually like clashing with the fire almost opened up an opportunity, but he hit the Lariat again.
Repetition sometimes isn't your friend. Not enough armor on that up B, that's for dang sure. If you ever have to recover low, I think LZ Glow is going to take that spot easily.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh,
okay, we're seeing these. Hold on. Oh!
Like, Dog hit, like, all the tech, but just could not finish.
That's one of those things where, like, I'd clip this, right, and then just, like, edit another clip where I, like, took a stock later. It doesn't have to be the same character. You can put it, like, a Duck Hunt or something in that kill pit. It doesn't matter. Everything before that, beautiful.
The Smash Ultimate Combo video deepfakes.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta get that AI-generated one at the very end.
I was thinking about the most cursed thing. I was thinking about, like, you know, like, oh, what would you think, you know, if AI tried to generate, like, Smash content? But, like, really, like, how bad do you think it would be, you know what I mean?
That would, like, be hilarious.
Like, really bad.
I don't think it could last a stock.
Yeah.
Without, like, some character, like, turning into an amorphous blob.
Right. Like, I'm morbidly curious just to see, like, what does the computer think we're doing? Like, is the computer just going to spam me at zero? You know what I mean? Like, or...
I mean, we have the amiibo, so we can test that.
True.
We need to do, like, an amiibo raised wrongly. Just, like, get an amiibo and teach it the dumbest nonsense. It's like we basically, like, it's a form of child abuse.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, is this like the juvenile hall of what do you call them? Amiibos?
Exactly. It's like this one is that we held them back a couple of years. this boy ain't right. Definitely.
I'll put this amiibo in the microwave for a little bit. It'll work right. I thought it would level them up faster. I don't know.
I mean, that's electricity, isn't it? I thought electricity would make it function better.
So are we in a generation now where, like, do you remember, like, the birth of, like, people and iPhones and, like, the whole, like, you know, you can charge your iPhone faster by putting it in the microwave?
Yes.
Is that, like, a generation too far gone now? Like, do people forget that happened or weren't alive yet? Is that a thing now?
I don't. I feel like there's definitely, like, a fake news problem where people are going to get caught with that. But
yeah.
you just keep seeing that for random nonsense. Like, I am not ready for, like, the AI-generated images, like, and having to explain to my mom, no, this isn't real.
Yeah, right.
That is the terrifying part. But the question is there going to be an overlap between, like older folks and incredibly younger folks? Like, is Gen Z going to get caught up by that?
That, low-key, yes, I think so.
Oh, no.
But the same way that this kid got held up by that attack and Zenit Glows losing that stock, I'll tell you what.
Smooth transition.
Yeah, right?
Smooth transition.
Uh-huh.
Almost as smooth as this string right here as Gabe catches the Alolan Whip on the tech read. See, I learned from the best.
Yeah, right? Oh my god!
Turn your back to the man, take two steps away, and then let it rip.
Oh my god, just flung it at him like that. It's disgusting. So, all right, actually, I got some beef with Sunfish, because we got the fella who's about to win Redemption. He's who took me out of Main Bracket. And then my first round was Squid Plum. Like, did you want me to come back? Like, what? Why did you do that?
He gave you the last seed possible.
Yeah, right?
Exactly. It's like, I don't know the vanilla Cena GameCube controller before. Doesn't he a professional Parcheesi player? No, that guy plays Pokemon Puzzle League. That's it.
I'm nasty at that. Hold on. So, you know, it's funny. Cole and I were talking about it, you know, especially because we've been so detached. Small Battlefield really has become, like, the new neutral, huh?
Yeah, PS2 is a counter pick, I believe.
Yeah,
so, like, folks really let this rock. And
I'm here for it.
I will eventually grow to hate this one, too. But for now, I'm fine with it.
Oh, okay. Maybe that's where I'm at. I might be in the blissful new.
Yeah, exactly. It's new enough where I don't have to see PS2, so I'm okay. I have like a visceral reaction anytime I see a green stage now.
Yeah.
It's like to take me to greens, and I still get the PS or the post-traumatic stress disorder. Yeah, I gotta workshop something with PTSD, but it's like PS2SD.
You're on to something.
Exactly.
You're on to something.
Not post-traumatic, it's like post-PS2 disorder. We'll save that one for the major.
Yeah. We got to workshop that one. You're right. This guy plays very aggressive.
That part of that's like the Incineroar difference, but yeah, he definitely like throws out a little bit more risky hitboxes than one would typically expect. He really wants to jump. Like, he's just getting hit by here to death by LG Glows right now.
Ooh. Nice sneak in to give overcome that yo-yo.
We have buttons, though. Safety. Just ditch the platform. Nice little back here right there, trying to catch LG Glows rushing in, but the patience of this best mate, solid so far.
Ugh.
That move is underappreciated.
So true. It's just like, it scoops so much more than you might expect, and it's so much stronger than his little legs look. Like, he's definitely a skips legs day guy,
yes.
But he kicks like he does.
True, yeah. He just got them stiletto heels on to compensate.
Must be.
Yeah, you are right about the skip leg day thing. Like, look at this man. This man's biceps is bigger than his thighs. That's the problem.
Right.
This dude has never, like, carried anything in his life. Like, we do our lifting sitting down.
Yeah.
Great grab. Can't get the sweet spot on the forward air, though. This is smash attack time. Oh, or that, or whip. Not
nice.
Gonna kill at 50, though.
Almost, though. God. What was that?
No, the bounce. You can't go down with it. Like, there's an angle. If you hold down when you're trying to get to that corner, then you'll bounce off like that.
Oh, no. That is unfortunate.
We are maybe one revenge away from an even game.
Yeah. Oh, never mind. One back throw. Yep, there we go. Good job to LZ Glows for not letting that go. Keeping on top of that. Closing that out. I definitely would like to see some adjustment. I don't know. I feel like Nissan is being super aggressive. I'm not really sure how LZ would counteract that, though.
It feels as though in that game, we didn't see the haymakers. Like, we did not see Ness die at 50. We didn't see a smash attack connect, no forward tilt or anything like that. That's really it. Just don't screw up, and then you've got the neutral unlocked. Like, LZ Glows understands what he's doing when he's actually gets space to swing. But in scramble situations, the Incineroar only needs to guess right a couple times.
Well, you know, space to swing. I don't know why Nissan brought him here then.
Yeah, this would have been like a Smashville pick potentially on my side. So I play this
yeah,
devilish fiendish cat.
I was gonna say that's right. You do partake in the.
I am a bad
heresy.
Person. Yes.
Yeah.
This is definitely a me character.
So true.
It's like I like all commentators play Incin. I swear to God, I don't know what it is. Like Kimona plays Incin. Last plays a little bit of Incin. Skip plays a little bit of Incin.
That's the new commentator character.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
It used to be Rob.
Actually, yeah.
Where a lot of, like, in Smash 4, a lot of people just play that character because he wasn't, like, good, but he was funny.
Yeah, that's all I can say about him. That's right. He was all right.
Yeah, he was solid.
Solid metal.
Oh, my God. 70%. Yeah, you're dead.
Yeah, so dead.
Thievery. Now we're playing the don't get grabbed game, and Nissan guessed correctly a couple times until he DI'd that back air atrociously.
Yeah. Ooh. All right. I'm liking this patience here at the ledge. Very reactive to a lot of these recovery options.
Even waited out the double jump, he just couldn't get the punish going. Like, a couple aggressive options coming out from LZ Close, and it feels like Gabe has the understanding of it, just cannot get the hitbox out.
Yeah. Oh.
It's just such a checkmate, dude. If you don't have your double jump, you just die.
Yeah, that is a rough part of this matchup for sure.
He made that back. That was an immaculate recovery. I was too busy watching Gabe just like crouch walk forward. Instant crouch walk. Don't die. Up tilt, no, up smash. The tiny tech flub right there.
Oh my goodness, LZ
stock and forces a game five.
Wow. That was a good, like just that last whole minute, he tapped in.
Yeah, 100%. It's the same thing, like Gabe got stock one with a Nalolan whip at like 70. Mm-hmm. Looked like he was gonna be in the driver's seat the whole time, and then LZ just punched it and said, you know what? I am here to do work.
Clearly.
Instant run back, saltiest of run backs.
LZ, I mean, really both of them. They've had a, I don't know, I feel like they've had a pretty good composure throughout the whole set, which is great, you know? You love to see this, especially when it's very, like, back and forth like this.
These jumping options here, Nissan Al Gabe, you need to stay grounded, shield, get a parry, just do not. You know, swing, try to anti-air nest. That is a recipe for disaster.
Yeah, that forward air is a little bit too sparkly. Got a little bit too much going on.
Great snatch immediately, 71%. In an awkward spot, we roll for the forward air. I love that option, just barely misses it.
Oh, great get up attack. Crazy.
Like aggressive with the upbeat too. It's just good recognition of when you can actually be passive versus aggressive with that tool.
Ah, the forward Mario back throw.
I know, right? This character has like four kill throws. It's kind of silly.
Oh, speaking of.
That's a tried and true. Had it since 64. Do not get back thrown by Ness.
Ooh, all right.
The walk-up grab.
This is an insanely even game five.
Yeah, it feels like whoever's going to get this next stock may very well start to walk away with it.
Nissan's got to be careful with these Danguish call it lariats. Punished for a couple of stray ones that he's thrown out. Ooh.
So probably going to go for the turnaround back here right there.
You talking about instant?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can basically, like, it's a 50-50 situation. If they hold it, you just go for the back air and they die super early. That is a short man. That child should not have gotten snatched up by that. But a full-grown man, that would have gone. Interrupting
nice.
The Alolan whip into immediately getting the stock, that is annoying.
Hey, speaking of annoying, like, these two, it has been immediately, like, trade for trade, stock for stock. And I could not imagine more tense, more apt game five situation than that. Double forwarder situation. Can't keep him off stage.
No! Glows, you saw the jaw drop right there.
I could not think of a worse game five situation.
Yeah, I'm just trying to hype it up.